Hi, I'm Dan Burns. I'm the physics curriculum and training specialist at Pasco Scientific, and I'm here today to talk about our new SmartCart vector display. The SmartCart vector display comes with a cable to connect it to a SmartCart, a USB cable for charging, and a screw attached to it allows you to mount it firmly to the SmartCart. And then this goes into the accessory port. And now you're ready to display force, acceleration, and velocity. And so right now it is displaying force as I grab and push and pull on it. If I want to display acceleration or velocity, I need to change those settings in the Capstone or SparkView control panel. And so I'm going to change it to acceleration. And so now it shows acceleration. The magnitude is indicated by the number of arrows you see, and the direction obviously is the direction of the arrows. And so we're going to show you some of the things you can do with this with your students to help them understand vectors and the difference between force, acceleration, and velocity. So the SmartCart vector display allows you to ask your students to make predictions about the direction and magnitude of velocity, acceleration, and force, and then they can see whether their prediction was correct or not. In this case, I'm going to give the cart a shove up the ramp. It's going to coast up the ramp, and I'd ask them to predict what would be the direction of the velocity as it's coasting up the ramp, and then when it's coasting back down. And you can see that it displays it, and they probably had that one correct. What if we change it to acceleration, though? What might they predict about that? And so now with acceleration, as I'm shoving it, it'll show an acceleration up the track, but as soon as I let go, the acceleration is down the track. It's down the track while it's coasting up and back down. Now you can see that, but it might be better to make that even more visible. And so I can adjust the range for the acceleration using Capstone or SparkView, the latest release. And so I'm going to adjust the range of the acceleration from 5 down to 1. And so do the same thing. Whoops. And now it's a little easier to see. The acceleration is down the track as it coasts up and back down. And also at the highest point. The acceleration is constant and down the track as soon as my hand is off of it. Now we put the SmartCart and the SmartCart vector display on an incline and connected a spring to them. I've also added some weights here, so there is room to still add the Pasco stacking weights. And so this is the equilibrium position. You can see we marked it by a piece of tape. And I zeroed the force sensor, so the sum of the forces are 0. I'm displaying force. And if we started oscillating, you can have students predict what will be the direction of the net force on the cart when it's above the equilibrium position or below, and then you can test it out. And you can see that when it's at the equilibrium position, it goes through 0. When it's on this side, the net force is down the track. Mg sine theta is pulling harder than the spring is pulling up, and then when it's past equilibrium position, the net force is parallel and up to the track. The spring is pulling harder than mg sine theta, which is typical of simple harmonic motion. Now you could also ask them to predict the direction of the velocity and the direction of the acceleration. So let's try the velocity. So I just changed the measurement in the control panel. Now it's measuring velocity. And so when the cart's moving up the ramp, its velocity's up the ramp. When it's going down, down the ramp, and it's 0 at the endpoints, at least momentarily. Predicting the acceleration might be a little tougher, but if they've already done the force prediction, they might realize, hey, the force, the net force is in the same direction as the acceleration. So when the acceleration is down the ramp, it's above the equilibrium position. When the acceleration is up the ramp, it's below the equilibrium position. The acceleration is 0 right in the middle and greatest on the ends. Now, there's a way to show your students both the acceleration and the velocity at the same time, but you would need two SmartCart vector displays. So let's set that up. So now we have two SmartCart vector displays, one on red SmartCart, one on the blue. The red one I have displaying acceleration, the blue one velocity, so we can do the same oscillating cart demo, but now you can see both acceleration and velocity at the same time. So you can have students predict the direction of each at various points in the motion. And then they can see if their predictions were correct with the visual display of the SmartCart. Now, up till now, we've been using the position sensor in the SmartCarts to tell us the magnitude and direction of the velocity and acceleration. But you can also use the internal accelerometer on the SmartCart and do applications holding the SmartCart and other ones. So let's take a look at one of those. So now we've put the SmartCart vector display and the SmartCart on a track, and the track is on a spinning chair. We use the legs of the track to secure it to the arms of the chair so you can spin it at least gently. Now, one problem is we can't see the vector display. So if I tip it over on its side, it fits right there in the SmartCart for viewing. So you could do this in front of a group of students, or they could be doing it on their own, and they can predict the direction of the force and the acceleration of the cart, and then check it out. So I have it displaying force now. So let's see what happens. If we spin it, we can see the force is toward the center, or in Latin, it is its direction is centripetal, as we hope the students would predict. For the acceleration, we've been using the acceleration measured by the position sensor in the SmartCart. So that wouldn't work here. But another option is to display the acceleration being measured by the built-in accelerometer that the SmartCart has. And so we've been seeing acceleration. Now it's from the built-in accelerometer. And it also shows the direction the acceleration is toward the center. And thus, that's sometimes called the centripetal acceleration. And so this helps your students understand circular motion as well, and spinning chair not included. Okay, we have our two SmartCart vector displays attached to SmartCarts, and I've put the magnetic bumper accessory that comes with the SmartCart on there. We're gonna look at collisions, and I've set them up to show the force on each, but look what happens as I bring them together. The blue one, obviously, that's incorrect. On the control panel for the SmartCart vector display on either the latest version of Capstone or SparkView, you can change the sign. There's this little checkbox, so I'll do that. And so now it shows the direction of the force correctly. So you can see in collisions whether they're both moving toward each other, or one is initially stationary, or the other one's stationary, or you can change the masses. You're gonna see visually that the forces are always the same on each cart in magnitude, but opposite direction. And with smart carts, you could also do that with a graph as well. But the visual confirmation of their predictions is a powerful learning tool. To find out more about the smart cart vector display and how to purchase one, just go to pasco.com. You'll also find information on the activities you've seen and more if you go to the resource area and look in our experiment library for SmartCart vector display activities, again, on our new website, pasco.com.